Hi everyone, today we'll look into the basic architecture of cognitive radio. This video is posted on the request of a subscriber named Venkat IIIT. The basic architecture of a cognitive radio addresses about the distinction between endogenous and exogenous components. An exogenous component executes and enforces external policies. Further, it addresses the radio's impact on the external environment and ensures that the behaviors of the radio satisfy the constraints imposed by the external regulations and policies. For example, an exogenous component can assist the radio in avoiding spectrum interference while searching for spectrum opportunities. Conversely, an endogenous component internally optimizes the performance of the radio through selection of operating modes and other parameters. The abstract architecture of cognitive radio comprises of 8 basic components. They are sensors, radio platform, radio frequency, policy enforcer, system strategy reasoner, policy conformance reasoner, local policy repository, and global policy repository. We'll see in detail about each of these components in the forthcoming slides. Next comes the sensors. In a cognitive radio that implements dynamic spectrum access, sensors are used to collect the information from external environment and discover the available spectrum and transmission opportunities. Next, the RF components are used to transmit and receive signals. The radio platform includes the digital signal processing and software control. Further, it provides interfaces to communicate with the other components like RF, sensors, information source and sync, and policy reasoners. Next comes the system strategy reasoner, which is an endogenous component in cognitive radio. It forms the strategies to control the operation of the radio. Further, these strategies reflect the spectral opportunities, capabilities of the radio and waveform, and the needs of the network and the users. Next comes the policy conformance reasoner. It is an exogenous component. It executes the active policy set to ensure that the radio transmission conforms to the policy. Next, the policy enforcer acts as a gatekeeper between system strategy reasoner and radio platform. Further, it ensures that all the transmission decisions sent from the system strategy reasoner to the radio platform comply with the active policy. Next, the global policy repository. It stores all the policies and specific subsets configured for specific networks. Further, it is shared across the network. Next, the local policy repository is within the system strategy reasoner. It can download the policies from the global policy repository through an interface. Further, a node can store multiple sets of policies, but only one set of policy is active at any time. We know that system strategy reasoner, that is SSR, is the most important component in the cognitive radio architecture. In this slide, we'll see the interaction between SSR and the other components. First is the interaction between SSR and PCR. In this case, the SSR sends query or request to the PCR when the radio needs to change its transmission strategy, or at the end of the validity time period for a permitted transmission opportunity. Next comes the interaction between SSR and RF. Here, all the incoming messages from the radio frequency first go to the radio platform. Then the data message goes to the information sink, whereas the control message ends up in the SSR itself. Similarly, all the outgoing control messages are generated by the SSR and passed through the policy enforcer to ensure that all the control messages conform to the policy. Then the policy enforcer forwards the control message to the radio platform. Here, the outgoing data message and control message will be merged in the radio platform and then sent out through the RF. Next comes the interaction between SSR and sensor. Here, the sensor collects the information of the environment, discovers the spectrum and transmission opportunities. Then, the analysis of the sense data can occur in the sensor or in the SSR. The SSR can also send control messages to the sensor. There are 5 complementary perspectives for a cognitive radio architecture. The first perspective defines about the functional components and design rules of a cognitive radio. The second perspective defines the cognition cycle, which shows the core capabilities of cognitive radio. The third perspective defines about the inference hierarchy, which examines the related levels of abstraction of cognitive radio. The fourth perspective defines the architecture maps, which shows the mathematical structure of the architecture. The fifth perspective defines how a cognitive radio can be built on an SDR. That is, it shows the evolutionary path from software radio architecture to cognitive radio architecture. Finally, we also know that cognitive radio architecture is expressed in radio extensible markup language, that is RxML. A more detailed information relating to cognitive radio architecture with respect to CRA 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 are given in chapter 4 of this book. If possible, have a look on it. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this video to be useful, subscribe it and share it with your friends. And don't forget to click that like button because it will motivate me to post more videos. Thank you once again.